Right guys, I'm just going to show you these ducks over here. Bobby, hear it raining. They are looking for food. And as it's been raining on the grass, worms come up, don't they? And they hit the ground. And the ducks are feeding off the worms, which is pretty cool. Some more over there. Hey, bye bye, duckies. Cyrus! You can't really see anything. I'm just pointing everywhere. Who's that? It's hard to see anything anyway.
Yeah.
I'm just pointing and open. Oh yeah. Cyrus! Thank you. peaceful walk on the ferry. Well, not on the ferry, but this is where the ferry comes up to get its passengers.
Daddy!
What? Okay. Just tell me what to walk then. Yeah, we thought we'd spend the week here. Knott End slipway.
Oh, I don't want to go.
No, we don't want to go to slipway, do we?
No thanks, I don't want to go on slipway.
No thanks. No, thank you.
What are you doing with that?
Nearly, we're nearly at the end. ferry there. From Knott End to Fleetwood, which is over there. I'm sure it says something around here. See it there? Down in Loon Deep, far below the sea, something sparkles like sunken treasure. Cool. Guys, we're at Cleveley Beach now, about 20 minutes away from where we are staying, so it's pretty cool. There she is. No, you're not going over there to the dog. It's Cyrus. That's our dog. What? Are you digging?
Sorry?
You trying to find some treasure? It's hard to see when recording. It's hard to see when recording because can't see shit all. I know, yeah. Jade, come on.
Come on, darling.
It's a nice day. Oh dear me.
Not too sure if you can see over there, guys, but the Blackpool Tower. See on the screen is my reflection, so it's hard to see anything, guys, so I do hope you can see it. The Blackpool Tower. It's pretty nice. And peaceful.
Yeah?
Wet, isn't it?
Oh!
these pets. Well, listen, I've had a bad bit of bad news myself. My Louie, who we shit to, who was 14, I got up and he'd had a stroke. So I took him into the vets and they said, oh, we'll do everything we can for him, but he had a bad heart and he was going blind, he was going deaf and he had arthritis and all sorts. So the vet rang up and said he's in a terrible state and I think it's best, you know, if we put him to sleep. So I've lost my Louie, and the other day I had to take Olga because she's got a growth on her leg, which is a tumour. But because she's only got one kidney, the operation would be too much for her. You know, they have to inject it with fluid, they have to do skin grafts. So we're just letting things, you know, settle, see how we go. I know, it's a dream. Do you know what? I keep saying I'm never, ever getting a dog again, because you invite a dog into your life or any animal, and inevitably you invite heartache, don't you? But then you look at the hangover when you're at the party, do you? You might as well enjoy it. Anyway, that's my saga, so I'm not having much luck. So let's see what we've got here then. We've got condolences to Danny and Mark, and they're in Michigan. Is that in England or the States? It's, I know there's one in the States, but you know, there's also a, like, Birkenhead in America, who lost a Catahoula leopard dog monkey recently. He was 14, our same age as my Louie, and was adopted by Danny and Mark when he was just 8 weeks old. Some fellas, I'm really, really sorry, I know you feel. And Tony and Jackie and Mosley of Birmingham, they emailed to say that their beautiful guinea pig Coco had died, and it sounds as though he brought a load of joy to your family, that old Coco. Julie Hunter, I'm sorry to read about the passing of your beautiful boxer Molly. Even though 11 and a half is a good age, I bet that your other boxer Rebus and your little Yorkie Cass are finding life strange without him. Boxer. I nearly took Carmine, didn't I, when I was filming in Battersea? Why didn't I take him? He was such a character. Because I thought I was going on tour, and of course it all went you-know-what up. So I never bothered, and I've ruined the day ever since. It's going to be an old staffy for me next, or a boxer. Listen to me, I've started already. And more sad news, this time from the Hopkins family in Merthyr Tydfil, because their chocolate Labrador passed away last month after 12 energetic years, leaving the family heartbroken. And apparently she was a gentle giant who touched so many people with her wonderful nature. So you sleep tight, Sash. I love labs as well. I love all dogs, full stop. Why didn't you get a dog, Malcolm?
Nothing with you, isn't that?
My cheek. I take that as a great compliment. I really do. Anyway, as promised last week, here's something from a wonderful woman. She's one of my mates, I'm happy to say, and she recently celebrated her 90th birthday last weekend. So if you're listening, Dame Cleo, this is especially for you. Embraceable you.